Hello everyone. So here in this problem, we have to evaluate limit x tends to 0 tan x minus sin x upon sin cube x. So first of all, I'll assume the given limit as L. So here I'll say let L equal to limit x tends to 0 tan x minus of sin x upon sin cube x. Now, first of all, we'll substitute the limit x tends to 0 in the given function and we'll check whether we are getting indeterminate form or not. If we are getting indeterminate form, then we'll apply the L'Hopital's rule to make the limit finite and then we'll find out the answer. So, for that, I'll substitute x as 0. So, here we'll get tan 0. Now, we all know that tan of 0 is 0. So, we'll get 0 minus sin 0, which is again 0, upon sin 0 is 0. So, it means we are getting 0 upon 0 for the given function. And whenever we get 0 upon 0, we say it is indeterminate form. And to make the limit finite, we have to apply the L'Hopital's rule. So, here I'll say, therefore, by L'Hopital's rule. Now, by L'Hopital's rule, we'll find out the derivative of numerator in the numerator and denominator in the denominator. But my friends, if you'll observe the given function, then here in the numerator, we have trigonometric function, or I can say the transcendental function, and in the denominator also, we have the transcendental function. And if we will find out the derivative of this, then for sin cube x, we will get 3 sin square x into cos x. And again, if we'll try to find out the derivative of that term further, then the sin and cos terms will increase and the derivative will become complex. And hence, to reduce the limit, it will take a little bit of time. So, here I'll apply a different approach where I'll make some substitution by which to evaluate this limit will become easier. Now, what is the substitution? So, what here I'll do is, first of all, I'll divide and multiply the given function by x cube. So, this will become tan of x minus sine of x upon x cube. So, here I am dividing. Simultaneously, I will multiply with x cube. So, this will become x cube upon sine cube of x. And my friends, if you will observe the second bracket, then here we can apply the property of limit x tends to 0 sine x upon x is equal to 1. So, here we can take cube outside so that we can get x upon sin x. So, the sin x upon x is also 1 and x upon sin x is also 1. So, by taking cube outside in the bracket, by applying the limit, we will get 1 and the 1 cube is 1. So, this term will directly become 1. And now, we just have to apply the L'Hopital's rule for the remaining term. And now, if you'll observe, then in the denominator, we got the algebraic function. And for algebraic function, to find out the derivative is a very easy task. So, let's find out the derivative by L'Hopital's rule. So, here it will become, therefore, L equal to, now this will become 1. So, limit x tends to 0, derivative of tan x is sec square x minus sin x derivative is cos x, derivative of x cube is 3x square. Now, after finding derivative, we will check whether still it is indeterminate or not. So, for that, I will substitute x as 0. So, by substituting x as 0, this sec of 0 will become 1 and also cos of 0 is 1. So, 1 minus 1 here, I will get 0 and 3 into 0 square is 0. It means still I am getting 0 upon 0. So, I will again apply the L'Hopital's rule. So, by L'Hopital's rule, for this function. So, by L'Hopital's rule, we will get the derivative of sec square x is 2 sec x and the derivative of sec x is sec x into tan x minus derivative of cos x is minus sin x, so that will become plus of sin x upon derivative of 3x square is 6x. Now we'll again substitute the limit, that is x tends to 0 over here, to check whether we are getting the finite value or not. So by substituting x as 0, here we'll get tan 0, that is 0, so this whole term will become 0, plus sin 0 is 0, so we are getting 0 in the numerator, and here 6 into 0 we will get 0 in the denominator. It means we are again getting 0 upon 0, that is indeterminate form. It means we have to again apply L'Hopital's rule. So I'll again apply the L'Hopital's rule for this new function. So for that, first of all, I'll write down the function properly. So this will become 2 times sec square x into tan x plus sin x. So here we'll get, therefore, L is equal to limit x tends to 0 2 times sec square x into tan x plus sin x upon 6x. Now we can apply the L'Hopital's rule on this function, but let me tell you, my friends, there is one more way to solve this function, and by that way it will become very easier to get the answer, and that way is nothing but we'll divide the two functions separately by 6x, so that in the first function we can get the term tan x upon x, where we can apply the formula, and here sin x upon x we can apply the formula. So therefore this will become L equal to limit x tends to 0, first term will become 2 sec square x, I am keeping tan x separate, and by dividing with 6x, I'll take 6 here and I'll keep x here. So we are getting the term tan x upon x plus here we'll get 1 upon 6 sin x upon x. So again we are getting the term sin x upon x as we got previously. So at these two places we can apply the formulas, and the formulas are limit x tends to 0 tan x upon x, or limit x tends to 0 sin x upon x is equal to 1. So the values of, or the property says that tan x upon x and sin x upon x, if limit x tends to 0 is 1. So I'll substitute it as 1. So here we'll get, therefore, L as limit x tends to 0, this will become 2 sec square x upon 6 plus 1 by 6. And now we'll substitute x as 0 over here. So this will become sec 0, that is 1, and this will give us 2 by 6 plus 1 by 6, and this is nothing but 3 by 6, and therefore the value of the given limit is 1 upon 2. So here we got the finite value for given limit. Thank you.